The improvement of the stage and the breakthrough of the movement technique had made Jake's next match much easier, whether facing the seated warriors from the four directional regions or those from the central domain. He could easily win the match without even using the spatial transcendence. When he finished the 392nd match, he finally met an opponent who forced him to use this most precious resource, however. "According to Avery, you are the champion of the ranking competition in the southern domain. Your strength is even greater than Avery's," declared the opponent, who was from the western domain. "Although I am the number one disciple of the ranking competition in the southern domain, I don't think I am a match for Avery," Jake offered in a tone of modesty. "I feel that you are no match for Avery either. The southern domain has always been the weakest territory in the Eternal Continent. I'm shocked it could produce two peerless geniuses," the opponent pressed. "Enough, let's cut the crap. I'll give you two options now. Either you admit defeat or die," Jake spat back.
"I'll choose the third option, and that is your death," the opponent pronounced with utter confidence.
Jake's anger surged. With his supreme level body, the movement technique that was about to break through to the Earth rank, and the Overlord fist that had mastered the essence of the seventh level, he made his first.
"The spatial transcendence is the true king. Without the help of the spatial transcendence, you won't be able to control your fate," the opponent mocked.
After that, he directly used the sixth level of the spatial transcendence and merged it into the profound grade advanced martial skill, intending to kill Jake right away. Boom! The fist technique collided with the martial skill that contained the spatial transcendence, creating a loud explosive sound. Along with the explosion, countless cracks appeared on the arena under their feet.
Damn it!
Seeing that he couldn't defeat Jake even with the sixth level of the spatial transcendence, his opponent immediately became furious. Meanwhile, rubbing his sore wrist, Jake couldn't help but agree with his opponent's evaluation of the spatial transcendence. His supreme level body had already felt the strain when facing the sixth level of the spatial transcendence of slaughter. If his opponent had been any stronger, he could well have had to use more than his physical strength to overcome him.
"I can already borrow the strength of the ninth level of the spatial transcendence. Just now, I only used the sixth level. Therefore, I will give you a chance to make a choice now that you have more information. Will you admit defeat, or do you want to die?"
the Western Region warrior declared with a proud expression.
"Let's see how it all pans out,"
Jake offered cryptically.
"Infinite slaughter."
Jake's rebuttal had infuriated the other party. He immediately used his trump card, planning to eliminate Jake in one fell swoop.
"Destroy the heavens and extinguish the earth."
With the help of the ninth layer of the spatial transcendence, Jake used the secret technique that the White Tiger Holy Sovereign had taught him. And because Jake was deploying the destruction spatial transcendence, which was among the most powerful types, he had the absolute upper hand, especially when one took into consideration his supreme level physical body strength. Soon, the battle was over, with Jake as the victor. Jake should have been happy to be able to kill the strongest warrior from the western region and obtain more than 200 feet of fortune dragon from him. However, at this moment, he was looking at the void outside the isolated space with a serious expression on his face.
"It seems like an unforeseen event has arrived. I must quicken the pace of the finals. I need to advance my strength to the peak as soon as possible," he declared,
newly focused on moving through the next rounds with the utmost rapidity. In the 393rd match, his opponent was the strongest person from the northern region. Jake didn't waste any time and directly used the peak ninth layer of the destruction spatial transcendence. Then, he combined it with his supreme level body and destroyed his opponent's divine soul. After that, he absorbed the opponent's fate dragon. In the 394th match, the opponent was the strongest expert from the eastern region. Jake used the same method to destroy the opponent's divine soul, and at the same time, he captured the energy dragon from his opponent's body. In the 395th match, which was against Avery, Jake did not immediately attack. Instead, he queried his friend,
"Senior Brother Argento, I know that you have been winning continuously until now. I also hope that you can win the championship of the Hidden Dragon List battle with your undefeated record. But I don't know if you have sensed anything unusual about the Hidden Dragon List this time.
No, Avery shook his head and replied.
Avery, you and I know each other from the Asura secret realm. You have always taken care of me. I will always remember this kindness in my heart, and I also believe in your character. That's why I want to reveal a secret about me.
Jake knew at this point, having faced some of the strongest warriors from the other domains, that Avery was no match for him. Still, though, he did not want to fight him, or rather, he did not want to blow him out of the arena. Thus, he intended to reveal the secret of his mastery of the spatial law in exchange for Avery's willingness to retreat. Jake used the sound transmission technique to convey the information. Avery was shocked and proclaimed, "So it's true." Avery had never thought that Jake would be able to grasp the power of the spatial transcendence. For a short time, he found it hard to accept and appeared to be struggling to collect his thoughts. Jake ventured in a sincere tone,
"Senior Brother Argento, the moment the Hidden Dragon List battle ends, I will let you witness the power of the spatial transcendence with your own eyes. Therefore, I hope that you can take the initiative to admit defeat, so that I can better deal with the upcoming changes."
"Junior Brother Hampton, since you are proficient in the power of the space law, I am truly no match for you. I appreciate the opportunity to bow out of this match gracefully, so that I can face the next one at full strength. I should be the one thanking you," Avery offered.
His sincere request and the unforeseen events that he often mentioned made Avery choose to believe in Jake in the end. Before he admitted defeat, he also wanted to express his goodwill. After Avery took the initiative to leave the arena, Jake stayed put. He continued to use the 400-foot Dragon of Fate to comprehend the spatial transcendence while waiting for the next round of the competition. After more than 300 matches, over 140 warriors had lost their lives. As for the remaining four matches, besides the strongest person from the Eastern region, the remaining three opponents were all from the Central Domain, and they were the ones who had intimidated Jake at the outset of the Hidden Dragon List battle. However, with the help of the Fate Dragon, Jake's stage had been enhanced. The comprehension of the spatial transcendence and the breakthrough of his physical body level had increased his strength by at least a few thousand times. Therefore, these three warriors no longer posed a threat to him. Apart from the strongest expert in the Central Domain who had exposed part of his trump cards, the other three opponents were easily dealt with, and as a result, the strongest forces from the other regions immediately developed a deep sense of animosity toward Jake. Yet Jake had no regrets. He forcefully seized the Dragon of Fortune that came from the body of the strongest expert in the Central Domain. Yet just then, the void was torn apart. A huge palm stretched out from the ripped spatial zone. It grabbed at Jake, who was standing on top of the arena.
"Junior Brother Hampton, dodge!" Avery shouted from the sidelines, hoping to help his friend.
Jake shook his head at Avery. He calmly looked at the giant palm. His eyes were filled with a strong, fighting spirit. When the giant palm was less than 100 feet away from Jake, the void of the isolated space was torn apart once again. From the ripped void, a black giant dragon that was thousands of feet long flew out. The dragon roared at the giant palm and then swung its tail, aiming for the palm's wrist. Seeing the black giant dragon flying out from the void, a trace of joy flashed across Jake's face. Boom! The huge palm was slapped by the powerful force of the dragon's tail, allowing Jake to avoid the fate of being captured.
"Bartleby, how dare you spoil my plan?"
An angry roar came from the huge palm that was sent flying.
"Old heaven-devouring demon, if you dare to touch my disciple, I will kill you,"
the black giant dragon roared at the giant palm.
"Humph."
After hearing Bartleby's roar, the giant palm let out a cold snort. Then it suddenly exploded, and countless gray energy gathered into an old man. When the giant palm transformed into an old man, The dragon gradually shrunk until it turned into a middle-aged man who emitted a strong killer instinct.
Old demon, after being severely injured, you were able to recover so quickly, and your strength has increased by a level. I have to say that you are indeed extraordinary,
Bartleby commented in a grave tone. When he heard Bartleby mention what happened in the past, the heaven-devouring demon suddenly burst into laughter. His tone was filled with disdain as he commented,
Oh, you are referring to the injuries inflicted by the Emperor of the Argento Empire. At the time, I was only able to use 3 levels of strength. If I had been fighting at full strength, it would have been easy for me to defeat him.
Oh, are you that powerful?
Bartleby queried in disbelief.
I knew you wouldn't believe me, so I'll let you experience it for yourself. I will reveal my true strength,
the heaven-devouring demon emperor claimed with pride. He roared, and then his entire body turned into a mass of gray gas. A vortex gradually formed in the middle of the gaseous cloud, and the vortex formed a powerful suction force. This suction force, in turn, acted on Bartleby's body, and soon Bartleby lost all control of his physicality.
Damn it, Bartleby shouted.
At the beginning, he felt a slight pressure from the suction force formed by the vortex, but in less than a second, the suction force of the vortex increased by thousands of times. He could no longer control his body and gradually approached the vortex. When Bartleby was less than 1,000 feet away from the vortex, the void of the isolated space was torn apart once again. Then, a chessboard appeared in the torn void. It hovered in the sky above Bartleby. Then, 36 chess pieces flew out from it. The 36 chess pieces started to affect the suction force of the vortex with a profound energy. In the end, Bartleby was freed from the fate of being sucked into the vortex. With the sudden appearance of the chessboard, Jake let out a long sigh of relief. Then, with the help of the complete fate dragon, he began the most important transformation of his life. Meanwhile, seeing that Bartleby had been saved by the sudden appearance of the chessboard, the heaven-devouring demon emperor returned to his original form. He looked at the chessboard with a calm expression, then proposed,
To be able to deploy a formation that can affect the force of the heavens and earth like that, this could only be the work of a level 1 formation master.
Heaven-devouring demon emperor, it seems like everyone in the world has underestimated you. Your current strength is no longer weaker than that of the immortal god from the ancient era. You could no doubt be considered the strongest man in the eternal continent,
proclaimed a middle-aged man who had appeared atop the chessboard.
Oh, to be able to see through my true strength with just a glance, I assume you aren't someone from that era.
The heaven-devouring demon emperor ventured, his tone grave. Ignoring the emperor's guess, the middle-aged man commanded,
Brother Bartleby, you'd better gather all the sublime supreme-level experts from the southern domain, because no one in the southern domain is a match for the heaven-devouring demon emperor. Only by working together can you defeat him.
Brother Alwyn, is the situation that grave?
Bartleby ventured.
It's even more serious than you think.
Sighing, Alwyn added in a bitter tone,
Although the heaven-devouring demon emperor's stage is still at the sublime supreme level, his true strength is even greater.
Right, right,
Bartleby mused, with full knowledge that Alwyn's background and age gave him a deep understanding of such matters. Bartleby used a special method to find out what was inside the isolated space. He told the sect leader, Lewis, everything in detail, and hoped that Lewis could gather all the sublime supreme level warriors in the southern domain, especially the Argento Empire Emperor. From Bartleby's point of view, only the Argento Emperor Talvin, who had once defeated the heaven-devouring demon emperor, could pose a threat to him. Seeing Bartleby calling for help with the secret technique, the heaven-devouring demon emperor didn't stop him. Instead, he looked at Bartleby with anticipation, as if he was hoping that the floating cloud sect elder could recruit more helpers. and for a sublime supreme level expert who had merged with the spatial transcendence, time and space weren't a problem at all. 30 seconds after Bartleby used a special method to send out the signal, the void of the isolated space was torn apart once again. This time, a young man in his 20s appeared in the ripped spatial zone.
"Master, hello," Pierre declared.
Next, Louis appeared. He turned to Pierre and proclaimed,
"I am satisfied with your performance in the Hidden Dragon List battle."
Then he turned to the Demon Emperor and declared,
"Greetings."
The Demon Emperor stared at Louis with a solemn expression and then mused,
"To be honest, whether in terms of the Southern Domain or the entire Eternal Continent, your talent is ranked 3rd. You are only 2nd to me and that Argento Emperor. If given tens of thousands of years, you might well be able to move beyond the Sublime Supreme stage."
"You flatter me, Demon Emperor, but I'm afraid we are not similar at all,"
Louis responded modestly.
"What a pity. What I need is a servant who can be obedient and loyal to me forever. Given your talent and personality, I'm afraid you won't be able to submit to me. Therefore, I can only defeat you here to eliminate future troubles,"
the Demon Emperor shot back.
"And I would welcome the challenge,"
Louis responded fearlessly to the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor's threat.
"If you want to kill Louis, you have to get past me first,"
a domineering voice sounded out as the void was torn open yet again. This time, it was Talvin, the Argento Empire Emperor, who had appeared, and he was holding a formidable blade.
"The Sword of All Life,"
Talvin shouted, deploying a top-grade martial skill.
"Devour everything,"
the Demon Emperor shouted upon seeing the sword energy rush toward him. He opened his mouth wide and swallowed it.
"Not bad. Your strength has improved a little compared to when you fought me in the past,"
the Demon Emperor commented casually. Seeing that his sword energy had easily been consumed by the Demon Emperor, Talvin had a serious expression on his face. He appeared concerned. At this point, Alwyn commented to Bartleby,
"Brother, speak to Talvin. Ask him to help you gather all the Sublime Supreme experts in the Eternal Continent. Otherwise, after the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor has consumed the complete Fate Dragon, the stage will break through the limitations of the Heavenly Method Law and advance to an unimaginable stage."
"All right, I will,"
Bartleby declared, and then he flew to Louis's and Talvin's side. After hearing Bartleby's suggestion, Louis chimed in.
"Senior Brother Argento, Bartleby is right. The heaven-devouring Demon Emperor's strength has exceeded our imagination. I'm afraid it would be difficult for the 4 of us to kill him. If he were allowed to kill all the experts of the 5 large regions one by one, the entire Eternal Continent would probably fall into his hands. I'm afraid the Eternal Continent would be plunged into misery and suffering."
However, even with the progress of the Floating Cloud Sect's expansion, they had yet to come into contact with the other 4 regions. Therefore, Louis could only look to the Argento Empire for help, because only he had the ability to summon the experts of the other 4 regions.
"All right,"
the Argento Emperor nodded. Then he took out a dragon-shaped jade token from the void and injected it into the power of the Divine Soul. He told the experts of the 4 regions what had happened in the isolated space of the Hidden Dragon List battle. As the competition that could lead to the entire continent, the Hidden Dragon List battle's final competition had attracted the attention of most of the experts. Furthermore, the leaders of the 5 major regions could see what had happened in the isolated space using secret comprehension techniques. In particular, the experts of the other 4 large regions had long noticed the changes in the isolated space, so after receiving the call from Talvin, the experts from the 4 large regions of East, West, North, and South all started to tear apart the spatial zone around the isolated space. They appeared next to Talvin.
"They're all here,"
declared the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor. His face flashed with a smile of success when he saw the strongest experts of the 5 large regions that had appeared in the isolated space.
"Hurry up and use your strongest attack,"
Alwyn shouted at Bartleby, sensing that something was awry. After hearing Elder Alwyn's warning, Bartleby immediately used the body movement technique transformation skill he had obtained after breaking through to the Sublime Supreme level to unleash his strongest attack.
"Extinguish!"
he shouted. Not only had Bartleby attacked first, he had also used his most powerful skill. This made Lewis feel that something was not right, and he immediately used his most powerful attack to cooperate with Bartleby.
"Flower Blossom Fall!"
Lewis screamed. Seeing that Lewis had used his most powerful technique, Talvin and the strongest experts from the four major regions of the East, West, North, and South also used their most powerful techniques.
"Starry Sky Eliminator!"
the Demon Emperor shouted, deploying his most powerful technique in turn.
"Not good, not good,"
Alwyn commented. At the same time, a memory of a law that could pose a threat to even the top 10 laws of the Southern Domain flashed across his mind. This was the Devouring Law. Seeing that Bartleby and the others had fallen under the law, Alwyn lowered his head and looked at Jake, who was still cultivating. He merged into the chessboard, and then the entire chessboard collided with the spatial transcendence formed by the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor.
Boom!
As the isolated space shook violently, the chessboard, Bartleby, Lewis, and the strongest people in the five regions were sent flying. However, none of the seven people who were sent flying were in good shape. Not only were they seriously injured, but even the spatial transcendence that had fused into their bodies seemed to be on the verge of shattering.
"How is this possible?"
Talvin, who had managed to stabilize his injuries, blurted out in disbelief.
"I suspect that the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor might not be a human, because the spatial transcendence he fused with is based upon the Devouring Law, which is not one of the normal laws of the Eternal Continent. It is a law that human experts are unable to grasp,"
Alwyn commented in a low and sober voice.
"Right, I've heard of it. It is a law that can threaten all the others,"
Talvin offered.
"That's right. It seems like both of us are in danger,"
Alwyn concluded with a gloomy expression.
"So what do you think, my friends? Am I capable of becoming the overlord of the Eternal Continent?"
the Demon Emperor queried proudly.
"Don't even think about it,"
the strongest expert from the Central Domain shouted angrily.
"Since you are unwilling to surrender, I can only swallow all of you. After that, I'll use the energy and spatial transcendence in your bodies to help me advance to the Supreme Stage. After that, I'll conquer the five great regions,"
the Demon Emperor explained in a sinister manner.
"If you want to devour them, you still need to get past me,"
Jake intervened in a relaxed and confident voice.
"A mere divine soul stage ant dares to try and stop me? I think you must want to test fate,"
the Demon Emperor shot back. When he found out that the person who stopped him was actually the champion of the Hidden Dragon List battle, the next target he planned to devour, the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor felt that it was ridiculous and ironic.
"Heaven-devouring Demon Emperor, the others don't know about your background, but I know your true nature. All of it,"
Jake proclaimed, his gaze steady. After that, he took a step and rose into the sky. The spiritual energy in the isolated space turned into white beams of light, which then poured into his body. At the same time, the spirit beast in his sea of consciousness also began to pour pure energy into the isolated space.
Boom!
Along with a deep rumble, a powerful aura rose from Jake's body. This aura clearly surpassed the divine soul stage, and it contained a strong life force.
"So what if you have broken through to the longevity period? In front of me, you are still just an ant,"
the Demon Emperor mocked. Ignoring the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor's condescending words, Jake continued to take the second step. The energy that was rising from his body had also reached the second level of the longevity period. With the third step, the energy on his body had reached the third level.
Boom!
When Jake took an 11th step, an even louder roar came from his body. At the same time, a few hundred feet above his head, a vague trace of spatial transcendence appeared. It was a pitch-black spatial transcendence.
That pitch-black law should be the spatial transcendence of destruction. What is its power? The leader of the western region could not help but shout. Unfortunately, no one was able to give them an accurate answer. Without the slightest hesitation, Jake continued to rise into the sky. After he took a 12th step, the two types of spatial transcendence that appeared above his head gradually began to solidify. And when he took a 20th step, the spatial transcendence he had deployed appeared in front of everyone.
So what if you could break through to the Royal Stage Peak? In my eyes, you are just a somewhat ambitious little pipsqueak, the Demon Emperor declared with disdain.
Is that so?
Jake lifted his head and looked at the heaven-devouring Emperor. The corner of his mouth curled up slightly as he replied with a question. Without any hesitation, he took a 21st step.
Boom!
An even louder sound emerged from Jake's body. At the same time, the spatial transcendence began to descend. With the next step, it descended 10 feet more. When Jake took a 30th step, the two laws of nothingness and darkness circled around his body, one on the left and the other on the right, as if they were two divine dragons protecting him.
So what if he's at the supreme level peak? I can devour him with ease.
Although the heaven-devouring demon emperor's tone was firm, his facial expression gradually became serious.
Since a supreme level warrior isn't strong enough, then what about a sublime supreme level one?
Jake roared back. As he took a 31st step, the spatial transcendence that was circling around him merged into his body, causing the energy that was rising from his body to almost break apart the isolated space. Fortunately, the hidden dragon list, which had disappeared for a period of time, reappeared and reinforced the isolated space to prevent its collapse. And when Jake arrived in front of the heaven-devouring demon emperor, he took a 40th step.
Kid, I admit that I was wrong. You are the one who triggered the opening of the hidden dragon list ahead of time. But so what if you have advanced to the sublime supreme level peak? Are you a match for me?
The heaven-devouring demon emperor, who had placed his hands behind his back, continued to provoke Jake.
Among the myriad of laws in the world, there is one law that no human expert can borrow, control, and merge with. It is the devouring law.
Jake began to discourse, ignoring the demon emperor's comment. He paused for effect, then continued.
Heaven-devouring demon emperor, this is surely the law you have just deployed. Otherwise, you wouldn't have been able to defeat the five experts of the major regions so easily.
That's right. The spatial transcendence that I just used is indeed the devouring law. You can't borrow, control, and fuse with the devouring spatial transcendence, but I can.
The Demon Emperor confirmed in an overconfident tone, though the fact that Jake had been able to identify this law produced a trace of nervousness in his heart. Jake didn't mind the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor's forceful response. His tone was still calm as he explained,
"As far as I know, there are several entities that allow living beings in this world to grasp the devouring law. One of them is the soul-devouring tree that advanced by devouring thousands of living beings. One is the long-lost heaven-devouring food, and the other is the spirit-eating ant that once dealt a devastating blow to the continent."
After the introduction, Jake stared at the heaven-devouring demon emperor, who was gradually getting nervous, and continued,
"I know where the soul-devouring tree grows, and I know it is still in control of the devouring law. The heaven-devouring beast is scarce, there is only one, but it survives, and I have seen it. So, this leads me to the following conclusion. You, heaven-devouring demon emperor, must be some sort of spirit-eating ant who relies on devouring others' spiritual energy. Moreover, you must have escaped from the spirit-eating ant's secret realm after your consciousness exploded."
In fact, what Jake said just now was a lie. He didn't know where the soul-devouring tree was located. He had never seen a heaven-devouring beast before. But the reason he thought of the heaven-devouring demon emperor was that he had learned back in the Novara secret realm of a holy beast that escaped from that space.
and he had found its soul in the heaven-devouring demon emperor's sea of consciousness.
You, how did you figure it out?
The demon emperor stuttered, taken off guard for the first time.
I have been to the secret realm before, and I have also seen your sacred body there. I remember the aura clearly,
Jake continued, working to suppress the growing excitement at his revelation.
How is this possible? Before I broke away from the sacred body, I left behind the power of a supreme stage warrior. Even a peak sublime supreme level warrior would never be able to withstand the destructive aura,
the demon emperor declared in a tone of panic. As a spirit beast that had broken through to the holy beast realm, the heaven-devouring demon emperor's only weakness was the sacred body he left behind in the secret realm. Therefore, he was worried that Jake would discover the weakness of the sacred body and use it to deal with him.
Heh,
Jake chuckled and pretended to be amused. Instead of continuing to pester him about his origin, he wanted to have a battle with the heaven-devouring demon emperor. This would help him take the final step. At the same time, he could also feel that the reason why the heaven-devouring demon emperor appeared so panicked was he was afraid that he had possession of the holy beast corpse.
Heaven-devouring demon emperor, I can assure you that I won't use the holy beast's corpse to deal with you. I will use my true strength to defeat you instead,
Jake declared.
It doesn't matter. Even if you destroy my sacred body, I will at most sleep for 1,000 years after the battle. After 1,000 years, there will be no one in this world who can threaten me,
the demon emperor shot back, pretending to be unfazed.
Devour heaven and earth,
he then shouted, launching a sneak attack and hoping to eliminate Jake before the young warrior could exploit the weakness of his holy body.
Boundless sea of blood!
Seeing that the heaven-devouring demon emperor had chosen to launch a sneak attack, Jake immediately used the secret technique that he had prepared beforehand. It was also a blood demon's secret technique that could suppress the devouring law. With the help of the complete version of the Fate Dragon, as he raised the spatial transcendence, he also refined the fire element spatial transcendence that the Vermilion Bird Saint had left him. This enabled him to convert his purple blood. The moment the transformation of the purple blood was completed, he finally knew the true origin of this body that he possessed. It turned out that during the Great Desolate War, countless living beings died in the explosion of the formation. The endless resentful souls condensed to the divine soul of the sky-destroying divine ape, while the endless blood condensed into a boundless blood river. After experiencing the great changes of the desolate antiquity era and the metamorphosis of the heavenly method laws, a powerful living being was born in the blood river. This living being was called the Blood Spirit. Upon its birth, it had absorbed the blood of countless spirit life forms. The blood contained a portion of their secret techniques and their comprehension. With the help of the cultivation of these entities, the Blood Spirit had advanced to the supreme stage in ancient times. This force, who called himself a Blood God, had a multifaceted personality. Sometimes he was a god who was willing to help others. Sometimes he was a demon who killed countless people. Sometimes he was a handsome young master who had good manners. Sometimes he was a lewd drunk. When the ancient era broke apart, not all innate creatures died in the explosion of the formation. A portion of the experts who had already advanced to the supreme stage used a special secret technique to avoid the explosion of the formation and became the rulers of the ancient era. Among the overlords of the ancient era, there was a super expert whose strength had reached the supreme holy sovereign stage. This expert had an extremely beautiful and loving partner. One day, when the Supreme Holy Sovereign went out to conduct some business, the Blood Spirit happened to pass by the Supreme Holy Sovereign's training hall, and coincidentally, he was in his demon state. He forced himself on the Supreme Holy Sovereign's partner. In response, the Supreme Holy Sovereign brought countless experts with him and killed the Blood Spirit's soul. Yet it turned out that the encounter between the Blood Spirit and the Supreme Holy Sovereign's partner had produced a child. This descendant had inherited the Blood Spirit's cultivation talent. He had also inherited the strength of his bloodline, as well as his mother's human body and emotions. With the help of both advantages, the descendant of the Blood Spirit had performed well. In just 100 years, he had broken through to the Supreme Holy Sovereign stage and was known as the Blood Demon Great Sovereign. However, the great changes in the ancient era involved the strongest experts of the stage, which caused the Blood Demon Great Sovereign great challenges. In the end, his soul was destroyed. The body that Jake possessed happened to belong to the bloodline left behind by the Blood Demon Emperor. And thus he possessed the Blood Demon Great Method, which was a secret technique that the Blood Demon Emperor had used to suppress most forms of spatial transcendence. It was also the trump card that he used to run amok in the ancient era. The gray mass and the red blood cloud were tangled together. They were evenly matched, and it was impossible to determine the victor within a short period of time.
Elder Alwyn, is Jake all right?
Bartleby queried worriedly when he thought of the heaven-devouring demon emperor's background and the time Jake had spent cultivating.
I don't know. We can only depend on Hampton's own luck.
Shaking his head, Alwyn conceded worriedly.
Nothing can't be swallowed,
the heaven-devouring demon emperor shouted. Seeing that the first secret technique could not defeat Jake, the Emperor, who had transformed into a gray mass of air, immediately used an even more powerful secret technique. This put Jake at a disadvantage. Therefore, he also used a stronger secret technique to fight the Demon Emperor. The gray mass of air and the red blood cloud continued to entangle with each other. There was still no clear winner and loser.
Devouring Eye!
The Demon Emperor screamed as he deployed his strongest technique, hoping to eliminate the heavenly laws completely with his pure might. Looking at the eye that appeared above the gray mass of air, Jake, who was in the red blood cloud, immediately used the trump card of the Blood Demon Emperor. It was also a natural-born ability of his.
Eye of Punishment!
He shouted, harnessing the heavenly laws. The Devouring Eye and the Eye of Punishment had been fighting for nearly half an hour, but neither side was able to emerge victorious. The gray mass took the initiative to retreat, and then it turned back into the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor. Jake, too, returned to his original form.
Jake, I have always thought that Talvin and Lewis were the most talented people in this world. However, the difference between them and you is like the difference between heaven and earth.
The Demon Emperor stated in a solemn and admiring tone, stunned by the lack of effort Jake had exerted up to this point.
No, no, my achievements are nothing next to theirs,
Jake stated humbly, shaking his head.
Jake, although the secret technique I have is unable to defeat you, the spatial transcendence that I have integrated into my body is not something you humans can resist. Next, I will let you experience the fear of the Swallowing Law.
Declared the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor as he took a step back and a chaotic spatial transcendence appeared above his head.
Devouring Starlight,
the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor roared and used his most powerful technique.
Spatial Annihilation,
Jake shouted back, using the strongest technique left by the Azure Dragon, which could unleash the power of the Space Law to its maximum potential.
How is this possible? The Spatial Law is the innate law of the Azure Dragon. How can you control it?
The Demon Emperor blurted, now in a state of utter confusion at Jake's abilities. The spatial transcendence could indeed suppress the top 10 laws, but the higher the rank of law, the less effective it would be. And when it came to the top 3 laws, the suppressive effect of the Swallowing Law was almost negligible. Even the strongest experts of the 5 great regions could hardly believe that Jake had command of this law. Even Lewis and Bartleby were shocked. After all, the laws of space and time were only legends. They had never heard of anyone who could control this type of spatial transcendence.
Elder Alwyn, did you know that this kid was proficient in the power of the space law?
Bartleby queried in a somewhat sour tone.
Come on, don't be jealous. I brought Hampton along when I was refining, and inadvertently found out that he was proficient in the power of the space law. At that time, You were in secluded cultivation and breaking through to the sublime supreme level, so he didn't have the chance to tell you.
Alwyn stated in a straightforward tone. When Jake told Alwyn that he was proficient in the power of the space law, he only thought that Jake could borrow the help of the law. But what he didn't expect was that Jake could fuse the law into his body and unleash its utmost strength.
Senior Brother Hampton, show mercy!
Avery, who was standing on top of the arena, interjected. With the comprehension of the spatial dimension laws left behind by the Azure Dragon Saint Sovereign, and with the help of the complete Fate Dragon, the power of the space law that Jake possessed was not inferior to the swallowing law that the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor had mastered. Therefore, the result of the battle between the two types of laws was that the swallowing law was forced to retreat and was weakened to its most obscure point by the spatial dimension laws. Seeing that the situation was not good, the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor immediately thought of retreating. He quietly took a few steps back, then he turned around and tore open the void, planning to escape from the isolated space for the time being. Just wait. After he figured out how to counter the power of the space law, he would return and seek revenge on Jake.
You want to leave?
Jake roared in shock and dismay. As a spirit-eating ant that had lived for millions of years, not only was the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor powerful, he also possessed many unknown secret techniques. If he escaped from the isolated space, Jake was not confident that he could find him in the near future. Furthermore, with his current cultivation base, Jake planned to bring Alicia to find Earth. He was going to meet his parents, and he didn't have the time to look for the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor. Further, if the Demon Emperor advanced to the Supreme Stage, Jake was afraid that he wouldn't be a match for him. Ignoring Jake's scolding, the Demon Emperor had already stepped into the gap. Jake, who didn't know how to stop him, subconsciously threw the sacred body fragment that he had stored in the storage finger ring at the departing figure. Countless sacred body fragments discovered the divine soul hidden in the heaven-devouring Demon Emperor's sea of consciousness. In an instant, they formed the Holy Beast's corpse. At the same time, the Holy Beast's corpse produced a suction force that pulled out the divine soul of the Ant Queen that was hidden in the Demon Emperor's sea of consciousness. Seeing the divine soul behind the spirit-eating ant merging into his sacred body, Jake immediately used the spatial secret technique that could kill divine souls to make quick work of the Demon Emperor.
Spatial strangulation, he screamed.
However, as a divine soul that had once advanced to the Supreme Stage, it could adequately resist even this secret technique. It was difficult to kill the divine soul of the spirit-eating ant in a short period of time. The spirit-eating ant pleaded,
Young Master Hampton, please show mercy and spare my life. As the Holy Beast, I can be your sacred pet. Heaven-devouring Demon Emperor, I know it is still you, and I can't risk the threat of keeping you around,
Jake proclaimed, at the same time using the last trace of spatial energy left behind by the Azure Dragon Saint Sovereign to finish off the spirit-eating ant. The moment the divine soul within the spirit-eating ant was killed, a pure power of the divine soul rushed into Jake's sea of consciousness, allowing his stage, which had already reached the sublime supreme level peak, to break through once again. However, this time, the breakthrough was silent and no changes occurred. No one in the isolated space knew that Jake had broken through to the stage beyond comprehension, the true supreme stage. Just as his cultivation base broke through to the true supreme stage, the power of the space law that had merged into his body started melting, and it completely merged into his flesh and blood. When the spatial law reached his eyes, Jake suddenly found that he could see through the void. He saw countless planets in the void, but among these planets, the one that caught his attention was small, and its spiritual energy was unusually diffuse. This planet was called Earth, and it had been his home before he had transmigrated. With the help of the power of the space law, his divine sense extended to Earth. Very quickly, Jake locked onto a remote mountain village that he immediately recognized as his birthplace. when he saw a pair of old men enjoying the cool breeze under the shade of a tree in a human abode, his eyes could not help but shed tears. However, when his divine sense saw a young man crafting a stone sculpture not far away, his expression froze, because that young man was none other than Jake himself. What was going on? After feeling that there was no spiritual energy fluctuations coming from that young man, Jake used the true supreme stage divine sense to check that young man's memories. After checking the memories, Jake finally understood the cause and effect of the incident. Back then, when his soul transmigrated due to an accident, Jake was far away in the Eternal Continent, and it was in fact his soul rather than his body that had transmigrated. Perhaps it was because of the balance of time and space, or perhaps it was because of the magic of the heavens. But whatever the case, the two souls had exchanged bodies. After this first Jake had transmigrated to the Eternal Continent, after experiencing the initial fear, he gradually got used to his own. And the second Jake, who had experienced all sorts of hardships and had traveled to the Earth, likewise had adapted to his new identity and life. The Jake who had transmigrated to the Earth attached great importance to family. Moreover, he didn't really like modern technology. Therefore, he returned to his hometown. On one hand, he represented some version of the Jake who had transmigrated to the Eternal Continent, and on the other hand, he used his eyesight and deep comprehension ability to become the top artist in his town. At the same time, under the encouragement of his parents, he married a local girl and had children. After learning about the life of this Jake who had transmigrated to the Earth, the Jake who was in the isolated space sighed in his heart and decided not to disrupt the reality of his aged parents.
Master Bartleby, Elder Alwyn, sect leader, I'll go and pick up Alicia first, then return to the Hampton family territory right away,
Jake explained in a solemn tone. Then, without another word, he tore open the void and disappeared. His journey was complete. Hi guys, it's Tyler, the narrator of your very own show, Strongest Replication. It was a delight to take you all on the journey of this exciting show, and I can't thank you enough for making the show such a success. Although we've reached an ending with this one, I'm certain that this is only the beginning of your journey with us, so stay tuned and enjoy many more exciting stories, only on Pocket FM.